So here we get 3.6 divided by 18. And now all we're going to do is to substitute the values of the function at those particular points. So what I want to do is I'm going to spell it out so that you have a better reference. So you get 0.2 times e to the power minus 2, because that's the value of the function at 0.2, plus 4 times the value of the function at 0.8, which is 0.8 e to the power minus 0.8, plus the value of the function at 2, which is 2 e to the power minus 2, plus the value of the function at 3.2, which is 3.2 e to the power minus 3.2, plus 2 times the value of the function at 1.4, which is 1.4 e to the power minus 1.4, plus the value of the function at 2.6, which is 2.6 e to the power minus 2.6, plus the value of the function at 3.8, which is 3.8 e to the power minus 3.8. So that's what we're getting as the values here. And now what we're going to do is we have calculated these values for you. And this is what we're going to get. We're going to get 0.6 here. This is 0.6. And this is 3.8. So this is not 0.6. What is it? 3.6 divided by 18 is 0.2. And then multiplied by, we're going to get 0.1637. That's the first value. Plus 4 times the following values, 0.3594, the value at 0.8. The value at 2 is 0.2706. And the value at 3.2 is 0.1304. And then plus 2 times the value at 1.4, which is 0.3452. I'm only using 4 significant digits just to keep things simple. You can use more. If you are using this in a computer program, you'll be using as many as the computer takes. And plus 0.08501. So that is the value at 3.8. And if you calculate this value here, this turns out to be 0.8733. So this is what we get by using the six-segment trapezoid rule, Simpson's one-third rule, which basically implies that you are applying the Simpson's one-third rule 3 times, because you have to make each application of Simpson's one-third rule over 2 segments. Let's go and see what the true error is. We know that the true value for this particular integral is 0.8751. That is the true value. So the true error in this case is the true value, which is 0.8751, obtained by using integral calculus, minus 0.8733, which we just obtained by using six-segment Simpson's one-third rule. And this gives us 0.0018. And if I want to calculate the relative true error in this case, I'll get true error, which is 0.0018, divided by the true value, or the exact value, which is 0.8751, times multiplied by 100. And this value here turns out to be 0.2057%. So what you're finding out is that once you have started using six-segment rule, you're getting 0.2057% relative true error. If you want to see that when we used n equal to 2, the relative true error which we got was 8.73%. And when we are using n equal to 6 for this example, now we're getting a relative true error of 0.2057%. So you can very well see that by increasing the number of segments, our relative true error is decreasing quite a bit. Now, what we want to be able to do is that since when we are numerically solving such integrals, we won't be privy to what the true value is. Just like the true value here given is 0.8751, we won't have this knowledge, because if we would have this knowledge, we wouldn't be calculating it approximately in the first place. So what we want to be able to do is we want to be able to see that whether we can, by increasing the number of segments when we are going from 2 to 4 to 6 to 8, let's suppose, can we use that knowledge to be able to figure out how accurate our answer is. So in that case, what I've done is that I've used Simpson's one-third rule, multiple segment, and I made a table of what do I get as the value of the integral. So I have the same integral, 0.2 to 3.8 x e to the power minus dx. And I said, hey, let me see what do I get as the value of this integral, approximate value of this integral, for different number of segments. So what is the value? And then what I do is I calculate the relative approximate error. That's what I do. I calculate the relative approximate error. So nowhere am I using the true value to calculate the relative approximate error. So when I have two segments, I got 0.7987. And I cannot calculate the relative approximate error because there's nothing to compare it with. When I get four, I got 0.8673. In this case, the relative approximate is 7.910%. Then when I took six, I got 0.8733, which I just did. And I get a relative approximate of 0.6870%. And then when I took eight segments, I got 0.8747 as the value and 0.1601% as the relative approximate error. And now what I can do is I can see that, hey, this absolute relative approximate error has turned out to be 0.1601%. So it is less than or equal to 5%. What that means that I have one significant digit at least correct. But is it less than 0.5%? Yes, it is. So that means that at least two significant digits are correct in my solution. But it's not less than 0.05%, so that's where I have to stop. So that means that I can trust this 8 and I can trust this 7 in my calculation for 8 segments. So when I'm calculating this particular integral by using 8 segments, I can say with confidence that the 8 and the 7 in this answer of 0.8747 is correct in my approximation for the integral which is given to me. Now, if you are a little bit rusty about how I found out this number, for example, this relative, absolute relative approximate, I'm going to show it to you here, is that it is simply the relative approximate error is simply defined as present approximation minus previous approximation divided by the present approximation times 100 if you want to calculate in percentage. So if you look at this number here, 7.910, this is my present approximation, and this is my previous approximation. So the present approximation is 0.8673 minus 0.7987 divided by the present approximation, which is 0.8673 times 100. And this turns out to be 7.910%. So that's where I'm getting those numbers for the absolute relative approximate. As you can see that nowhere am I using the true value to calculate these numbers and also come up with the conclusion that how many significant digits are correct in my solution. And that is the end of this segment.